which is supposed to be Suratul Nisa, which is the women empowerment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has empowered the women in such a sense that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them the due respect, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept them like they are very, very precious. That being the reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, number one is, we talk about the mahar. In the sense that in pre-Islamic era, there was no mahar. There was no dowry given to a woman. A woman was regarded as a commodity. When the husband would pass away, she would become part of the inheritance. So it is the inheritors that would decide where the woman is supposed to go and what is supposed to happen to her. When the Shari'at al-Mutahara came, the Shari'at al-Mutahara says, no, وَآتُ النِّسَاءَ فَدُقَاتِهِنَّ نِحْنَةً. If you want the women, then get married to them according to the conditions and according to the guidelines given down by the Shari'at al-Mutahara. And not only that, but you are going to honor them by imparting your wealth and giving it to them as honor and respect. The second point was mentioned to say, لَا يَحِلُّ لَكُمْ أَن تَرِثُ النِّسَاءَ كَرْحًا. You cannot become inheritors of the women even though they dislike. That is not permissible. Then in the third part, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَتَأَخُذُونَهُ بُهْتَانًا وَإِثْمًا مُبِينًا. A woman is supposed to be very precious. She is supposed to be taken care of. She deserves all the respect. She deserves all the honor. So you are not supposed to put a slander against them without any valid reason.
www.jamiazainab.com.